Hey, my loves, it is Nurse Meg here, and I want to talk to you about three ways to manage stress when you're working in the hospital because, oh my God, of all times, we gotta talk about this. Now, of course, you had a lot of stress in nursing school, and maybe you chose some unhealthy ways to manage that. So I wanna talk first about unhealthy ways to manage your stress and then healthy ways to do it. So let's talk about what not to do to manage your stress. You're gonna have stress. Everybody has stress, every job has stress, everyone's life is stressful. No one has a perfect life, no matter what it looks like from the outside or on the Instagram feed, all right? So some of the unhealthy ways that I personally dealt with stress in nursing school is transferring my stress into anger and serving it up to my friends and family and loved ones. If you find yourself more easily ticked off, shorter fuse, snapping at people, choosing anger, judging, that is your stress talking, and that is something that you need to get a hold of. So we need to find a different way to let it out, because anger is an addiction, and when you choose anger over and over, your brain is like, that's where I'm getting my release. I'm gonna keep doing it. So be conscious of that. Another way is bad food and alcohol. I know it feels good, gives you a little a dopamine, but in the end, it is horrific on your body, and it is not relieving your stress. It's just temporarily distracting you, and it's still gonna be there. So whether you are escaping through alcohol, drugs, horrible fried processed food, this is not working for you. It's just distracting you for the moment. It's giving you a little hit of dopamine. Also, energy drinks. I know we all survived on energy drinks and caffeine and whatever you can put in your body to keep you awake and studying and retaining information, but we're not going to do that anymore. That is not a healthy way to manage your stress. It actually increases your stress because it increases your adrenal hormones, your adrenal fatigue. It's not going to help you. It's going to hurt you. So let's talk about healthy ways. Let's talk about three ways that we can positively manage stress. If you master this in your first couple years of nursing, you will have a long, prosperous career that you are proud of and that you love. So number one is to get outside. Get outside, get your bare feet on the ground, the sand, the dirt. There have been so many studies that talk about this thing called grounding, where the earth can literally like suck the stress hormones out of you, and it resets your sleep cycle. It helps you create melatonin and eliminate melatonin when you're supposed to. Breathing fresh air and putting your body on the actual ground really does something. Hug a tree. There also are some studies about like how trees can sort of help relax you and decrease those adrenal hormones. So maybe those tree huggers were onto something. Maybe science will explain this in the coming years, but try it. But just get outside and connect with nature. Countless studies show that. Go to the beach and just put your feet in the sand and touch the ocean. If you're not on any of the coast, just put your feet outside, touch a tree. I'm telling you, it works. I do it. I don't 100% understand the science behind it, but I know it works. And it's not harming me. Number two is exercise. Everybody knows that exercise increases your endorphins and is a great stress reliever. So whether it's a simple walk, if it's like 10 jumping jacks in the break room because you're so freaking stressed, what I used to do on night shift to keep me awake and relieve stress is I would go up and down the stairs. Like, you know, the stairwell, I worked on the fourth floor, and I would go down all the way to the bottom and up to the fifth, and I would go back up and down, up and down. It would keep me awake, and it also helped like relieve the stress of the shift. It's like when you use your body a lot, you can't use your brain at that same capacity. So go for a run, get on the treadmill, get your gym membership, whatever you need to do. Not so much about like losing weight or getting fit, but just release those hormones, sweat out that terrible shift you just had. I'm telling you, it really works. The third way to manage stress in a really good way is to connect with other humans. You gotta find somebody, a friend, a therapist, somebody where you can let it all out to, someone that you can vent to, who will not dismiss you or be like, oh, I don't wanna talk about that. Someone who will be a support and that you can be a support to as well. So you gotta find that safe person, that safe space to talk to vent to. It could be a friend, it could be a therapist, or it could be my DMs on Instagram. Come vent to me, I would love to support you. And a little bonus, I wanted to talk about managing stress when you're on shift. If you're having a really stressful day, or a coworker or a patient is just being borderline abusive and not contributing positively to your day, get away from the situation. So go scream into the linen cart, go cry in the supply room, let it out. Don't internalize it and say, I'm too busy to connect with my emotions right now. I'm too busy to acknowledge what is happening. You gotta acknowledge that, because it's gonna seep out the sides where it's not supposed to if you don't deal with your emotions. So learn these things early. Those are my three ways to manage stress in the hospital setting for my beautiful, wonderful fellow nurses. Let me know if this video helped you. I would love to hear your feedback, or maybe if you have some really good coping mechanism suggestions, I'd love to hear them in the comments. Of course, always let me know where you're watching from, and if you made it this far, like the video and subscribe to my channel for more just nursing support and whatever you need. If you have a video request and I don't have a video for you already, let me know in the comments. I'll make a video just for you. So thank you for watching. I will see you in the next video. Bye.